Nothing marks fall better than the spookiest, craziest, and sweetest night of the year. Halloween! Unfortunately, we are in the middle of a global pandemic, so things are very different for our trick-or-treaters and pumpkin eaters this year. So we decided to visit young families across the country to see how they're doing and even get some cool tips from the mommies and daddies on how to safely celebrate Halloween 2020. Let's start in Beaver State in Portland, Oregon, with a mommy near and dear to us.
Hi, I'm Mishy from Portland, Oregon. Halloween is the absolute favorite holiday of my oldest kid. I don't even know if he knows what Christmas is because his whole life is focused on Halloween. This year, unfortunately, pandemic season, we're not sure what's going to happen. I'm not sure if we're even allowed to go trick-or-treating in our neighborhood. So we were able to form a pandemic pod where we have just families that have agreed, okay, we'll hang out with each other, but no other families will be included. But our kids are close enough in age that they can all play together and then the adults all get along. Give them something to look forward to, give them something to be excited about, and then hopefully you can also give them activities that are small and manageable that they feel are rewarding for them.
Now, let's slide on over to the Silver State in Reno, Nevada.
Hi, we're the Lim family from Reno, Nevada. Crackers!
Yeah?
Well, Halloween is important to my family because she loves trick-or-treating. She loves candy. She experienced it first time last year. I don't know if we're going to do that this year. I'm being a mom. I don't know. I'm scared. I don't know how safe that would be. And I kind of don't want to risk it for candy. She can still wear her costume and we'll take pictures, post it on Facebook or something. So I don't know. Right now, it's kind of up in the air. Let your kid experience everything they can. I try to keep her as safe as I can. Whenever I work out in the garage, which is almost like every day, sometimes twice a day, she stays with me there. She hangs on the bars. Wow, so she does planks with me, obviously not correctly, but she tries. And she sits on my back when I'm doing push-ups.
All right, dudes, let's pop in our friend's backyard in warm Long Beach, California.
Hi, I'm Mika, and I'm a mom to Dia, who is 4, and Day, who is 1.5, from Long Beach, California. Things are definitely different this year. We still want to go with our theme costumes and decorating our place to continue that Halloween tradition. But I think instead of calling our friends and family to come over to go trick-or-treating, I think we're going to try to hide candy around our house and our yard so they can have a treasure hunt with candy in our own safe space. We have a lot of cardboard boxes from our recent move, and I've just been gathering craft supplies my whole entire life. So I just need to go through my stash instead of going to the store and just really like challenge myself in looking at materials.
And let's fly across the country to the heart of the Sunshine State, Kissimmee, Florida.
We're the Hidalgo family from Florida.
Go for it.
Halloween is important to celebrate with our family because it makes us take the time to spend together. And of course, the candy is very important.
So during the pandemic, we're gonna, you know, like go around the neighborhood, collect some candies and chocolates and dress up for Halloween. And we're just gonna try to do it, you know, with hand sanitizer, with like maybe a long stick to collect the candy. And instead of giving them candies in person, I'm thinking of putting them in bags and then leaving them out outside on the table. But I noticed as the weather changed and then he noticed that no one's visiting, then he started to feel sad. He was starting to think that his family didn't want to visit him. So we had to explain, you know, about the coronavirus again. And, you know, his grandparents are elderly. They can't fly or travel. It's not going to be safe. and it's not safe for us to just visit them.
The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention offer these great tips for us to be safe and healthy on Halloween. Wear a mask, do not forget. Maintain social distance at all times. Costume masks are not alternatives to protective masks. If you are throwing or going to a party, do them outdoors and small groups only. Check your city or county's Halloween regulations. And if you can, stay home. Have a staycation or virtual party with friends and family. And as the holidays draw near, our families share their thoughts for the season.
We're Filipinos. Holiday season is definitely family time, party time. Definitely important. But again, safety first.
We have so much to be thankful for. Even though it's very scary out there, from the pandemic to political things happening, magpasalamat na lang tayo na that we're still here and we still have a chance to change things.
This is the start of a new tradition, not necessarily a bad thing. So kind of just really not so much dwell on the past and how things were back then, but just really adapt to how things are and see the positive of things.
It'll be different not being around all our relatives, but I think it's a little bit of sacrifice now would be better in the long run.